and we are out on the Central Line. It is a warm summer's day, and finally, we're getting to do the least used station on the whole of the London Underground. It's the least used station on the Central Line.
The next station is Roding Valley.
Roding Valley is just outside the Greater London boundary on the Hainault Loop in Zone 4, and off-peak only gets a service every 20 minutes. That's the least frequent on the tube network. Originally opened in 1936 as Roding Valley Halt by the London and North Eastern Railway, it saw steam trains run through here first until it was later absorbed by the London Underground Network, which it became part of in 1948.
There's no one else here. No one. Which is what you would expect for the Underground's completely least used station. Right?
Even though it's the least used station on the whole of the network, it's still got dot matrix indicators, litter bins and waiting rooms, and this ticketing area, but it is one of the 12 stations on the network not to have ticket barriers. On the Labyrinth is in the waiting room on the westbound platform, but I headed for the waiting room on the eastbound platform.
It's a very calming, almost zen-like experience being here. Here is now in the echoey waiting room on the eastbound platform. We'll do some passenger figures. 5 years ago, it was 0.24 million. It then increased slightly over the next 2 years to 0.26 million. And then the last 2 years and the year that we last have statistics for, it rose again to 0.37 million passengers a year. It's that many per day. Most of those are in the morning peak and then evening, coming and going into central London to and from work. Apart from that, the rest of the day, it's very quiet.
So Roding Valley has actually got an entrance on each side. Each side is step free. To get the step free access, you have to approach the correct side. There's a footbridge between the two, and amusingly, there's been some people coming through here. It's not a completely deserted station, but a lot of the people just use the footbridge to cross over. They're not getting the train, they're just using it as like a cut through. Another thing that it's worth noting here at Roding Valley is that most of the time trains just shuttle in between Woodford and Hainault, but due to the location of a Central Line depot at Hainault just down that way, if you look at the timetable, there are some trains highlighted in red, and I always thought that it was like Monday to Friday's peak hours only, but there are indeed three in the morning and then one in the afternoon about 4 o'clock which go through Woodford and carry on down into central London. But bizarrely, it also happens on a Saturday and even on a Sunday as well. There's one at 7:47 in the morning where it goes straight through.
This, by the way, is really good advice. Please carry water with you in hot weather. It is one of the warmest days of the year that I'm filming this on, but my advice would be to take that a level further. Don't just carry it with you, but actually drink it as well. So carry and drink. Time to go for a walk.
Because when I do these least used tube stations, I point out the facilities. One of the facilities is quite often, is there a bus stop, a connecting bus? And the one at Roding Valley is kind of here, but it's around the corner. This is the bus stop for the extremely rare and lesser spotted 549, one of the few London buses that I've never caught. Not including all the night buses, because on the timetable, in some places, it's up to an hour and a half between buses. And I would wait and catch it just for one stop, but I want to go for a walk and take you to see something else amazing instead.
So you take a short walk and you find why Roding Valley is called Roding Valley. Have you ever wondered why it's called that name? It's because, yes, there is a valley here. And here, down to my left, just here, this is the River Roding. And just here, is what I've come to see.
Thing is, when you think about viaducts on the Underground, you think of the Dollis Hill Viaduct, which gets a lot of fuss made about it up at Mill Hill East on the Northern Line. But the Central Line has got its own little viaduct here too, over the River Roding, at Roding Valley, sit, there's the water, there's nature, there's birds, sun's out, it's all good.
And so, for the last time, let's have a look at the chart to see how the Central Line compares to all the other least used stations on other tube lines, with Roding Valley's 250,000 passengers per year. Except, I then realised, as I caught a bus, that it doesn't have to be the last time.
And that is Roding Valley. Yes, I just got the 549 bus for one stop. Sorry, bus drivers, I know you hate it when people do that. I can now pick that off my list as well. That is Roding Valley, that is the least used station on the Central Line, and the least used station on the whole of the London Underground. We've done a whole series apart from the Waterloo City Line, that would be silly, of course, but that's not the end of the series, because we can still do the least used station on the Overground, the DLR, and the Trams. So there's at least three more to come.